Hello friends, welcome back to Stock Trading Tutor channel. I used to make tutorial video based on stock market. Guys, if you have not joined my free technical classes, then you can give a missed call on 960-6046-814. So friends, if you want to open a Demat account, you can give a missed call in the same number, or else you can visit my YouTube channel. Here you can see open a free Demat account. Link is provided here in the top. You can just click on this and easily you can open a Demat account. Else you can visit in my description box. I have provided the link below. So friends, today in this video we are going to discuss on the margin and M2M market to mark to market second part. Here in this second part, as we know, the future price fluctuates on the daily basis by the virtue of which you either send to make a profit or loss. Marking to market or mark to market is a simple accounting procedure which involves adjusting the profit or loss you have made for the day and entitling you the same. And as long as you hold the future contracts, M2M is applicable. So let us take a simple example to understand this. Assume on the 1st of December 2014 at around of 11:30 a.m. You decided to buy Hindalco futures at rupees of 165 and the lot size of rupees 2000, a lot size of 2000, and 4 days later on 4th December 2014 you decide to square off the position at 2:15 p.m. at rupees of 170.10. clearly, as the calculation below shows, this is the profitable trade. So buy prices were rupees 165, sell prices 170.1, so profit per share will be 5.1 rupees. So total profit here 2000 into 5.1, which is 10,200. So friends, however, the trade has held for the 4 working days. So each day the future contract is held, the profit or loss is marked or to the market. So while marking to market, the previous day closing price is taken as the reference rate to the calculate the profit or loss. So here 1st of December 2014, you can see 168.3 was the closing price. 2nd of December 2014, it was 172.4, and 3rd of December it is 171.4. And at last 4th day you can see 169.9. so the table above shows the future price the movement over the 4 days the contracts as was held. Let us look at what happened on the day-to-day basis to understand how the M2M works. So on day one at 11:30 a.m. the futures contract was purchased at rupees of 165. Clearly, after the contract was purchased, the price was gone up further to close of rupees 168.3. hence the profit for the day is 168.3 minus 165, which is rupees 3.3 per shares. So since the lot size is 2000 and the new and the net profit of the day will be 3.3 into 2000, which is 6600. Hence the exchange ensures via the broker that the rupees 6600 is credited to your trading account at the end of the day. But where is the most money coming from? So obviously it is coming from the counterparty, which means the exchange is also ensuring that the counterparty is paying up to rupees of 6600 towards his loss. But how does the exchange ensures they get this money from the party who is supposed to pay up? So obviously through the margin that are deposited in at the time of initiating the trade, but more on this later. Now here is another important aspect you need to note from an accounting perspective. The futures buying price is no longer treated as rupees 165, but instead it will be considered as rupees 168.3 closing price of the day. So friends, on the second day, if you talk about the future close at the rupees of 172.4, yeah, clearly another day is of a profit. The profit earned for the day would be 172.4 minus 168.3, which is 4.1 per share of rupees will be 8,200 net profit. So the profit that you are entitled to receive the credited to your trading account and by price is reset to the day's closing price, that is 172.4. So on the third day, if you talk about the future closes at the rupees of 171.6, which means this with respect to the previous day's closing price, there is a loss to the extent of 16,600, then 172.4 minus 171.6 into 2000, the loss amount will be automatically debited from your trading account, and also buy price is now reset to 171.6. so on the day 4, the trader did not continue to hold the position through the day, but rather decide to square off the position midday to 15 p.m. at the rupees of 170.10, and hence the respect of to the previous day close, he again made a loss, and that would be a loss of 171.6 minus 170.1 and rupees 1.1 per share, and 3000 will be the price. The net loss, needless to say, after the square off, and it does not matter where the future price goes, as the trader has squared off its position. Also, rupees 3000 is debited from the trading account by end to end day. So now let us just tabulate the value of the daily mark of mark to mark market and see how much money has come in and how much money has gone out. So here you can see the day one, 1st December, 165 was the reference price for M2M. Closing price was 168.3, and the daily M2M will be the positive 6,600, which is print profit. In the second day, it was a profit of 8,200, and in the third day, it was a loss of 1,600, and again in the fourth day, also loss of 3,000. So the total amount, if you see here, is 10,200. So well, if you summed up all the M2M cash flow, you will end up with the same amount that we originally calculated. So buy price and sell price, profit per share is 170 minus 165, which is 5.1, and here the total profit will be 10,200. So this is the way you can calculate the M2M. So the mark to market is just a daily accounting adjustment where the money is either credited or debited, and also called as the daily obligation based on how the future price behaves. So the previous day close price is taken into the consideration to calculate the present day M2M. And why do you think that M2 is required in the first place? Well, think about it, and M2M is a daily cash adjustment by means of which the exchange drastically reduce and the counterparty default risk, and as long as traders hold the contract, the exchange's virtue of the M2M ensures both the parties are fair and square on a daily basis. So now, keeping this basic concept of M2M, let us move back to the relook of margin and see how the trade involves during its life. So guys, thank you for watching this video. If you're having any queries regarding the margin or M2M mark to market, you can give a comment in the comment box, and as well as you can give a missed call on 9606046816. So friends, if you are new to this video, please subscribe, like and share.